major implications to that and major implications of nothing getting done on this front in Congress. As they continue to fight, millions of Americans continue to struggle. Families in Essex County, New Jersey, are being hit particularly hard. Just this week, a food distribution event hosted by the Community Food Bank of New Jersey quickly ran out of food. 1,000 boxes of food gone in less than 2 hours. We're going to talk about this with Carlos Rodriguez, president and CEO of that food bank, and Essex County Executive Joe DiVincenzo. You're both members of the New Jersey Governor's Restart and Recovery Advisory Council. Thank you for being with me. Carlos, if we could begin with you, what was it like to see that happen, to be hosting this event, to know that there are people in need, but to see the extent of it in person?
Well, it's heartbreaking, and it's an event that we've seen repeat in the months since the pandemic began. You know, families showing up, hoping for a little nourishment, and many of them showing up for the very first time or having to deal with the need for food for the very first time. On top of the many families who were struggling before and continue to struggle now in unimaginable ways. So it's just heart-wrenching, and we know that it's something that can be prevented and addressed.
One of the things that has struck me so much, Carlos, about your comments on this is your description of the shock in the faces of the people that come, the mothers that come, the fathers that come, people who had jobs, some people who are still, you know, working minimally, trying to scrape by, but don't have enough to provide. These are people that never in a million years thought they'd be in that line.
You know, I can't tell you what it is to see the face of a mom with a car seat and a child in the back and the look of what is clearly grief and concern as they pull up. And as you put food in the back of their trunk, to see them get a glance through their rearview mirror and just see a little bit of relief as they kind of drive away. It's just not something that you'd ever imagine seeing so consistently in the 5-6 months that we've been doing this.
So Joe, to you are the county executive there, and there's been so much made of how well New Jersey has done and Governor Murphy has done in terms of fighting COVID. I mean, so much so that they even opened restaurants at, you know, 25% capacity indoors this week, right? Saying our numbers are low enough, trying to help prop up those businesses. But when you look at the Johns Hopkins numbers, your county, 2,120 people have died from COVID, more than any other New Jersey county. So why are those in your community so vulnerable? And can you speak to what you're seeing versus, I think, the broader narrative is that New Jersey's doing pretty well, all things considered?
Well, listen, it's very concerning. What's happening here in Essex County, there's no question we have been hit the hardest here. You talk about the number of deaths, which is over 2,000. You talk about the positive COVID results, which is over 20,000. You talk about our unemployment rate right now is over 16.6 in Essex County. The people need help. They need everyone to pitch in together. You talked about that last food distribution with the Community Food Bank. We partner with them. Mm-hmm. We've been doing this every Thursday, traveling throughout Essex County, providing service for our residents because Carlos is absolutely right.
You know,
people are hurting out there, and it's people, you know, the food insecurity was always existed here in Essex County, but it's a lot worse now because of the coronavirus. We have a lot more work to do here.
I don't even know what, you know, political party you're affiliated with, and that's not what this is about. I think my question to you, Joe, is one to leaders of both parties right now. Congress is fighting. They are stalled. They are not doing their jobs. They are not reaching an agreement, yet both say we need more stimulus. So what's your message to them?
Listen, it's a political football game, and they're playing with people's lives. All right. Yeah. And it's wrong. Whether you're a Democrat, whether you're a Republican, whether you're an independent, they have to get something done. You have the Democrats put a plan for $2.5 billion. The Republicans came back and put $5 billion. They have to come to meet in between and get things done because people are hurting and we need their help in all kinds of ways. Let's stop playing with people's lives.
Yeah, important message. Carlos, before we go, if you could just speak to also the disproportionate impact that we're seeing play out again on minority communities of color.
Yeah, and it really is interesting to see how the numbers evolve in terms of food insecurity. It disproportionately affects black and brown neighbors, but it really does touch every single community and every demographic across the state. Of course, those that were vulnerable before, those that that make up the essential workforce, are the ones that are disproportionately impacted. Mm-hmm. And of course, so many of our families across the entire state, and as Essex County, just had jobs and were making ends meet. But again, they were one economic shock away from falling on hard times. And that's exactly what we're dealing with now. We know what's going to help. Hence, unemployment is going to help. Increasing the SNAP benefits is going to help. It just can't fall on the shoulders of charity alone.
No, it certainly can't.
Poppy, Carlos mentioned about this is happening throughout us. We have 22 towns. We have over 800,000 residents. This has touched every community. There's people for the first time that are online there that have never been online. It's so upsetting to see that. But we're there to help. We're there to support our residents and making sure they get to be able to provide food for their families, which is the most important thing.
Yeah, they're blessed to have the work that you guys are doing. Let's hope Congress gets its act together.